अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट सिक्स्थ लेसन, क्लास पीसी, सब्जेक्ट इज मैथमेटिक्स। दिस वीक इज फ्रॉम 11th मई टू 15th मई 2020। इन दिस लेसन नंबर सिक्स वी हैव टू डिस्कस टू टॉपिक्स। नंबर वन, फर्दर फंक्शंस, दिस इज चैप्टर नंबर टू। सम पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर वाज लेफ्ट इन प्रीवियस last lesson number 5, inshallah today we will complete it. Next, new topic is quadratic equations. This is again from the same book D3. This is chapter number 1 of this book. Methodology: audio aids, visual aids, educational videos and homework assignments. These will help us in this lesson. Brainstorming. We have simple questions just to refresh in your minds the concepts which we have already learned. What is a function and what is meant by image of an element? Yes, what is a function? Function is a rule which relates numbers from one set to numbers in some other set. First set is called domain set and the second set is called codomain set. What is meant by image of an element? When we use some value of variable x in given function, we find some answer. That answer is called image of that element. Now we have these three questions: what is a quadratic equation, what is the standard form of a quadratic equation, and what is the solution of an equation. These questions have answers in next slide, that is, an equation with highest degree of 2 is called a quadratic equation. For example, these are two examples. In these, highest power is 2 and highest power is 2, so these two are called quadratic equations. We know 1 degree 1 equation is called linear equation. These are two quadratic equations. Standard form of a quadratic equation: an equation of the type 3x square plus 7x plus 5 equals 0 is called a quadratic equation in standard form. Keep in mind, in standard form equation, these terms are arranged in ascending or descending orders, number one, and number two, there must be 0 on one side. These are two main features of standard form quadratic equation. Solution of an equation means values of the variables that satisfy the equation, or when we solve a quadratic equation, we get answers. Usually these are two answers. These are called solutions or roots of that equation. Objectives: by the end of this lesson, students, I hope, inshallah, you would be able to find the inverse of a function, evaluate inverse functions for given values of variables, find the values of unknowns with the given conditions, and solve a quadratic equation by factorization or by completing square methods. These are main objectives in this lesson. Inverse of a function: this is the reverse process of a function which gives us the value of a variable whose image is given. Example 1. Find the inverse of this function. Fx is a function given. Given function is fx, and we have to find its inverse. This is denoted by f inverse x. There are three main steps in finding inverse of a function. These are here. Step 1. We always suppose y equals to fx. Given function fx is always supposed equal to y. Then next step, x is equal to f inverse of y. This is a notation to be used here. How can we get this? Why we write this notation? This will be discussed or explained in next classes easily. You will understand, inshallah. Now, we have supposed here y equals to fx. So, using this value of y here, we get y equals 2x plus 1. Given function becomes like this. Now, separating x or finding value of x in terms of y, or we can also say that we are going to make x subject to the formula. For this, we have to separate x on one side. Take this one over here with negative sign. Then we are left with 2x divided by 2. this is the value of x. So x is what? Y minus 1 over 2. We have made x subject of the formula. This was the required task. Now we know here x was equal to f inverse of y. So using this value we get this equation, replacing this x by this value f inverse of y. Now this is required answer, but we have changed the variable throughout. We are using here y, but we were given variable x. We can change it without any objection. No objection. We can change x minus 1 over 2 equals to f inverse of x. We have replaced y by x. We can do in this working. Now we have to evaluate f inverse of 2. Just like a function, we have to use this value 2 in f inverse function over here. Simply use here 2 everywhere instead of x. Simplifying this notation, and we get f inverse of 2 is 1 by 2. This was the procedure to evaluate f inverse of 2. Example 2. Similarly, for a function h of x is a function, that is 3x plus 1 by 2, we have to find out its inverse, h inverse of x. Same method, we suppose y equals to h of x, then we write x equals to h inverse of y. Use this value of h x equals to y in given expression here. Y will be used here, okay. Now, we have to make x subject of the formula. It means we have to separate x on one side, getting answer in terms of y, okay. We multiply by 2, then we take 1 over here, minus 1. And then we divide by 6. This is the required task. X equals to 2y minus 1 over 6. Now replace again. X was here, h inverse of y. So use this value over here. We have this answer in terms of y. We can change here variable without any objection. We can write 2x minus 1 over 6 equals to h inverse of x. This is the procedure to find inverse of any function. We have to keep in mind these three steps in all these cases. Now for evaluation, this is not a difficult task. Simply we have to find out h inverse of 3, means use this notation and use here 3 instead of x over here and over here, okay. We write here 3 and 3 all over here. We get answer h inverse of 3 equal 5 over 6. Okay, now this is new topic, quadratic equation. This is chapter number 1 in D3. We are given a simple quadratic equation, 2x square plus 5x minus 7 equals 0. We have to find solution of this equation. We prefer to solve this by midterm break method because these are simple numbers and we can use here factorization method. For this we get 2 into minus 7, we get minus 14. Possible pairs are plus 7 and minus 2x, and minus 7 equals 0. We use these working steps here and getting this factorization of this equation. Now equating these two factors 1 by 1 equal to 0, we get answer this one and this one. These are two answers for this part. Now in B part of this example, x plus 3 whole square equals to 11. Yes students, this is very simple and important part of discussion. Whenever we are given this type of question or equation, something whole square equal to some number here, we always do it directly, taking square root on both sides. We get here x plus 3, and square root of 11 is plus minus 3.3166. keep in mind, square root of 11 is always plus minus, like this number, any number. Now we have two equations, x plus 3 equals something positive and x plus 3 equals to this thing negative, with negative sign. Now getting and simplifying this, we get two answers for x is here and x is here. These are two roots, answers or solutions for this equation given in this format. Example 2. We are given some expression x square plus 12x, and we have to write this thing in this format. Very simple concept. First of all, we find half of the coefficient of x. Here coefficient is 12. We find half is 6. Dividing this by 2, we get answer 6. Now, keep in mind, we always add and subtract square of this half. So, x square plus 12x plus we add 6 square and we get minus, we subtract 6 square in the same step. Now, these three terms can be enclosed in a bracket, getting x plus 6 whole square minus 36. This is a required format because we have written this thing in this format here. X A is 6 and B is minus 36. These are two points answers. Now, second part is similarly x square plus 1 by 2x. Half of the coefficient of x is 1 by 4. So we add 1 by 4 square and we subtract 1 by 4 square. Again, enclosing these three terms in a bracket, getting this identity minus 1 by 4 whole square as it is. Now, this can be written as 1 by 16 and this expression as it is. Again, this is a required format of what? X plus a whole square plus b. Here, by comparison, we can claim a is 1 by 2 and b is minus 1 by 16. Example 3. Solve this equation and give your answers up to two decimal places. Here, factors are not possible, therefore we use completing square method. First, we prefer to solve any equation by midterm break or by factorization method, but here this is not possible, so we have to use completing square method. Again, same cases here. Here, coefficient of x is 2, so half of it is 1. So we add 1 square and we subtract 1 square in the same step, minus 5 as it is equal to 0. Adding and subtracting, same discussion we have done in example 1b part. Now, these three terms can be written in a bracket, x plus 1 whole square equals to. These two terms which are extra here, these will be taken on the right side. By changing their signs, we get this expression 1 square plus 5, and now this is equal to 6 here. Now, this is the same question as we have discussed example 1b part. Taking square on both sides, we get these two as answers. Recap. We may have short questions to revise main concepts discussed and learnt in this lesson. For example, what is a function? A rule which relates numbers from one set to numbers some other set. What is a quadratic equation? Answer is simple. Any equation with highest degree 2 is called quadratic equation. What is standard form of a quadratic equation? Any quadratic equation arranged in ascending or descending order having 0 on one side is called standard form of quadratic equation. Okay, right. Students, inshallah, I hope you have understood this concept clearly and it will be very helpful to do your homework. Allah Hafiz.